Welcome back to Bay Area Focus. Dr. Amir Baluch is an author, entrepreneur, and an anesthesiologist, and he is here to talk everything from how to keep your wealth to what's happening in the healthcare world under President Trump. Thanks for coming on the show.
Thanks for having me.
Well, first off, you have this book. It's called Make It, Keep It.
Yes.
Right? The New Rules of Wealth Preservation for Doctors. What made you, what is the book about?
Well, the book's it's a little bit of a primer for physicians, just giving some general financial advice that we actually don't get in medical school or in college. And I actually wrote it based off some personal experience. My dad was a physician himself. I saw how many hours he was working, and he would go to conferences. He was always learning, but he would never learn about financial education. And actually, after years and years of working, he never actually accumulated everything, any real wealth. And so I thought this was kind of a problem for a lot of physicians, not just my dad. And I saw that more and more as I went further in my medical career. And so it just happened as I was doing some research on how people accumulate wealth. I read a statistic showing that about 80% of people that accumulate a lot of wealth do it with real estate. So we talk a lot about real estate in the book and where life insurance policies fit in, personal budgeting, just some basics to get them going the right direction.
It's interesting because a lot of people would think, oh, okay, a physician, a doctor, well, then you're making pretty good money.
Right.
But is it how it's invested?
Exactly. So you can make a lot of money, but if you're putting in the wrong investments and you lose it all, you end up with not very much or anything. And sometimes you could even be negative if you took a loan out for a certain business or medical startup or whatever the flavor of the week is. And unfortunately, physicians don't really know how to evaluate these investments, and nor do they even have the time, even if they knew how to do it. So one of the things I mentioned in my book is learning to partner with people that do have the time and the experience to actually evaluate a deal, whether it's real estate or a startup, a medical device, or anything. And that really helps protect them from losing money in their investments.
In the book, you talk about retiring early. So what is one thing in your book you mentioned that can help people retire early?
You know, there are a couple things out there that are not mentioned a lot out in public. One chapter I like a lot is this chapter on self-directing your IRA. So when you have a retirement account, a lot of people feel that the only thing that they can invest in is the stock market, mutual funds, and bonds. That's not actually true. You can actually work with companies that will allow you to invest in whatever you want, and you get a bank account and a checkbook, and you can make a loan to somebody and say, hey, I need 10% back on this loan. Or you could give a loan to somebody for a real estate deal if he can't purchase it, and you could hold title to the real estate as he pays you 12% return. You could even invest directly into a business if you want. So you're actually supercharging your retirement account that way and not having to deal with the volatility of the stock market going up and down.
Do you need to have a lot of money in order to invest and accumulate some wealth?
No, actually, you don't. So even a little bit can go a long way, or you could form partnerships with people, and the money could come from a passive investor while you put in the sweat equity, and you actually put all the pieces of the puzzle together and run the company. So that could be considered an investment, where your investment could be your sweat or your reputation or your experience or your specialized knowledge. An investment doesn't always include money. It could be something else.
Okay, so you're obviously an investor, but you are also an anesthesiologist. So we're talking
right.
Money and medical here. You know, obviously, it's been in the news lately with the Affordable Care Act and the Republicans trying to replace and repeal.
Right.
What is the state? From your point of view in the medical world, where are we at right now?
Well, we're kind of in limbo, I feel. And, you know, the healthcare world is so complicated with insurance and reimbursements and access to care. And it's hard to make everybody happy. You know, at the same time, in an ideal world, everybody would have coverage and it would be affordable for everybody. And if somebody couldn't afford it, they would still get it. And whatever they pay into the system, they'd be able to get everything covered in an ideal world. But we had to pick and choose. So we want to make it affordable. Unfortunately, that means they won't get access to all the types of care that they want. But if they do want more access, or they want more options, or they want to be able to choose their own doctor, for example, they might be paying a higher premium. So where's that happy middle? nobody really knows, and it's going to be different for every single person you ask. Everybody has a different opinion of what healthcare should be, and that's why, you know, it's just such a big dilemma, and we're trying to find a happy medium, and hopefully we'll come up with multiple options for patients where they could sit down and actually have somebody explain what their priorities are based off of their health situation and just make some informed decisions and buy an insurance policy that matches their priorities. I think that is the best that somebody can do right now.
I think that is the key, just understanding what it is you're signing up for. All right. Thank you so much for coming on the show.
No problem. Thanks for having me.
And for more information on the doctor and his book, Make It, Keep It, just log on to baluchbulletin.com. And coming up next, we are talking startups and Silicon Valley. We'll be right back.